Today we will discuss chapter 2, input and output devices. Children, in the first chapter we have discussed about the meaning of input and output devices. Now here we will learn in detail the types of input devices and the purpose for which it is used. Initially, children, when computers were introduced, that time the only input device which was used, it was keyboard, and those keyboards were mechanical keyboard. Rather, I remember my faculty used to tell me that in olden days, when just the binary computers, I mean now we have these high-tech computers with machine level language and also higher level languages. My faculty told me once that the first keyboard was having only two buttons. Do you know why? Because when the computers were made, that time it could understand only machine language, that is 0 and 1. So all the inputs, whatever we needed to feed inside the computer, it was first translated into binary language, and then through the keyboard this instruction was fed inside the computer and was processed by the CPU. So here we can say now we have basically three types of keyboards. The first one is the mechanical keyboard. The second is our optical keyboard. Now we also have, children, wireless keyboard and multimedia keyboard. Now how will you know which is the mechanical keyboard and which is the multimedia keyboard? The keyboard with basic 96 keys, those switches on the keys are called as keys, like F button, X button. These are the switches. We call them as key, and the collection of entire keys is called as keyboard. So the traditional keyboard, where only numeric buttons were there, then you had function buttons, alphabet buttons, and special keys also, like space bar, enter key, arrow keys, at the rate, etc. So it constitute of basically four types of keys: alphabetical keys, numeric keys, function keys, and special keys. Apart from that, it did not had any extra keys. See, children, this is the mechanical keyboard. You will not find any volume button or Wi-Fi button or any other special Windows key. Do you have here? No. So this is the traditional mechanical keyboard. Also, now these type of multimedia keys are very common. In most of your laptops, you have these keyboards. Yes, you have seen. You have speakers button, you have mic button, you have all other basic control keys nowadays which are needed, even for the cameras to snap out or to stop. Then you have Windows key. So this is the multimedia keys. Basically it has, if you count, will be more than 106, some have 116. Some multimedia keys are highly advanced with 124 keys also. Each company's keyboard will vary in the number of keys. Now the virtual key is, children, quite different. You can see here in picture. It is through a projector. The person is typing it, keeping mobile on the table, but see, he is not accessing directly from the mobile. He is not typing using the mobile keypad. The person is, see, using the virtual keyboard. This is the recent latest release in the market, which will be very soon available in India also. Many countries are using this virtual keyboard. But keyboard is not the pointing device. It is a typing device. It is like a typewriter. We type, we press the switches. Whereas mouse is a pointing device. Remember why it is used? It is used to select, it is used to click, it is used to close. It is a shortcut for the keyboard. So many shortcuts we have. We can do directly with the mouse instead of using our keyboard. Correct? So this, the first one, is the old type of mouse. In some mouse you will see they have three buttons. In some of the mouse you will see they have two buttons, right click and left click. Whereas in those mouse which have two buttons, you will see if you turn back the mouse, there is a ball. And when you drag the mouse on the table, you will see the cursor moving on the screen. So you can say those three buttons are available in all the types of mechanical mouse. In three button mouse, we have right click, left click, and the center is the roller to scroll. Whereas in this type of mechanical mouse, right and left click is only available in the top part, whereas at the bottom you can see this roller ball is set here inside the mouse, which senses from the bottom of the surface of the mouse. Now see here, then the second type of mouse is the optical mouse. Now why it is called as optical? See, from the word we can understand its meaning. Optical has been derived from the word optics, that is light. So in such type of mouse you will see it is based on the phenomena of light. It senses light, and you will see a light also inside the mouse. Red color generally, or the blue color light, keeps on glowing till the mouse is actively connected with the CPU. But they are able to sense the location of the screen through light sensors. That is why it is called as optical mouse. Trackballs were generally used for playing, for the, you know, and even for huge computers like workstations and mainframes. You have seen trackballs in so many console games. You have seen, we have these type of trackballs. It is type of, you can say, a mouse, but it is basically used for selecting object, moving it. Now light pen. Children, light pen is also called as stylus. It is also a pointing device like mouse. You can directly bring the pen in contact with the screen and it will sense that area. It is the same feature, children, what we do it in our smartphones now. We touch and we open. Same thing is done with the stylus. Barcode reader. These type of readers you have seen in the shopping malls, in shops where they have products, and at the back of the product they have some codes. It can be a not always the codes with parallel lines. It can be a type of code with different pattern. These patterns contain some information. Data and information will right away go inside the reader, and it will be converted into electrical signal and will be fed inside the CPU. And then the CPU will analyze and read the information. Children, these are the handheld. Why it is called as handheld? Because it is very small in size. We can hold it in our hand. So these handheld barcode readers, as the person will flash light on these barcode, if the information stored inside this barcode, and what type of information it contains? It contains the product, its name, manufacturing date, and also the amount. All these information is fed inside the scanner, which is converted right in the CPU into electrical signal. The CPU will read and give the information on the monitor, that is on the output device. This is called as magnetic ink character reader. Here see, at the bottom of the check there is a special type of character. See, it is quite different from other font style. It is quite different. This is the check number which is sensed by the magnetic ink character reader. And if you touch, you please see at home, ask your parents to show you the check. You hold the check, close your eyes, and somewhere you will feel something engraved text form. That engraved text form is this number, which is written with a special type of ink. As the light is flashed and the check is put inside for reading, when the light will flash, this ink gets magnetized and the information of this check is then fed inside the CPU. What information? Check number, account holder, bank number. Where you have seen optical mark reader? We haven't seen, but we have seen the OMR sheet. Most of you must have given your Olympiad exams. There, when you appear for the exam, you get the OMR sheet in your hand. And for filling the OMR sheet, your answers, your name, roll number, everything, you only encircle, that is, you shade the circles. Children, because in handwritten documents, we write so fast in cursive writing. Sometimes when we are writing E or I, suppose I have written I and I forgot to place a dot above I. So, this was the problem with the character readers. But now, the readers which are available in the market are quite improved. Mics or microphone, because micro means small and phone means where the device with which you make a call, that is you can say sound or voice. Whatever I am saying, the sound what we produce is in it is in analog form, but when I am speaking, the microphone converts my analog form to electric signals. And later it converts it into digital form. Yes, that is why we are able to store all our audio and videos. Because everything, whatever we see, it is all in analog form. But when we see the same thing on the screen of computer or mobile, those are the digitized form, converted form. So microphone also is an input device.